Yo guys, today we're gonna cover another 5 super obvious features that you either knew your whole life or you discovered them just now after 200 years of using 3ds Max. So let's dive deeper into the known unknown depths of 3ds Max. Our first feature is gonna be place highlight feature. I bet you had tons of situations where you're trying to set up your lights manually, and to get those perfect highlights was always a tricky task to achieve. You would need to move your lights around and hope that you hit that right spot for that nice reflection to appear. Now, if you go to align section, long press, scroll down, there is a place highlight. So what place highlight does, when you select your light, it's gonna be moved depending on the location where you click on your desired object, in our case, our teapot. So if I long press here, the light is gonna follow the movement of the position where I clicked. So I can adjust my reflections just the way I want them to be. So I can place, for example, this one here, and let's say I'm perfectly satisfied with this. Our second feature is gonna be safe frames and field grid. I believe many of you know what safe frames are. If you click on the name of your camera here, scroll down to show safe frames, you're gonna see the output region of your render. If you click on the little plus button here and go to configure viewports, when you navigate to save frames tab, you're gonna see these options here. We have action safe, title safe, and user safe. Action safe was originally used in cinematography to show an area where a lot of televisions would crop their image, so this was considered a very unstable area to show critical information in. Title safe was used for subtitles. User safe is purely user defined. For this example, I'm gonna turn off title safe and action safe and just use the user safe. For example, if I need to show my sink here and I want it to be in, I don't know, let's say 40% of my image, let's click it like this. I can now easily maneuver the camera and position my sink so that it fits the expected range. Now, if we go back and click on the configure viewports, and if we turn off user safe and turn on 12 field grid, click apply, you're gonna see these. These are also useful to determine the composition of your image. If I need my tap to be perfectly in the center, I can now move my image and just position the tap so that the middle is on this vertical line. If we go back to viewport configuration again, we have 12x9 field grid. If we activate it, we're gonna get even denser grid, and now we can really fine tune where we want our items to be in our scene. For our third feature, we'll be covering a quad menu repeat last option. I don't know if this is the official name of that feature, but let me show you what it does. So for example, let's say I need to do some cuts here. So I'm gonna activate my quad menus and I'm gonna use a cut tool. So let me cut here and here. Next, let's say I need to use a swift loop. So I'm gonna activate my quad menus and I'm gonna use my swift loop again. Now, if I activate the quad menu again, you can notice that the cut is written in white letters, where swift loop is also written in white letters. These were the two options that I last used. The thing is, you see this empty area here where it says set and coordinates. If you click on any of these areas, it will activate these options again. So I don't need to run up for the cut. I can just click on this area and it will activate the cut tool. For swift loop is the same thing. If you click right here, it's gonna activate the swift loop. Now, you would think, how is this useful? Because it's not like I'm wasting so much time clicking on swift loop. It's literally 3 millimeters below my mouse. Well, it's a no-brainer thing. So every time when you right click, you literally do a click. You don't watch where you're clicking, and it just activates your last feature. So you don't have to think if you aimed it right, you know, found it anywhere, etc. So it's literally like this. It's very easy. And this works for every quad menu there is. Another example of this, I will show you with the unwrap modifier. So for example, I activate my edge mode, and if I want to select an edge here, and I need to do a stitch. So I find my stitch selected here. It's gonna stitch the remaining polygons. But if I click here again, I don't need to go to the stitch again. I can just click here and it's gonna repeat the process all over again. So this is a really nice hidden feature that I don't think many people know about. Our next feature is gonna be Quadrify All. Now, I thought that everyone knows about this feature, but from time to time I meet people who are struggling with models downloaded from internet that are full of triangles. So let me show you how you can detriangulate your object. First, your object must be in editable poly mode. Then you go to your ribbon, under the modeling section, you have geometry all, click on it, and there is a quadrify all button. Just one more thing, don't take this option for granted, because sometimes it does a really bad job with detriangulating stuff. So don't expect miracles. Our fifth and last feature is shape check. Now, I bet you had situations where you would download a bunch of vectors online, and when you import them into Max and you want to do an extrusion on them, it doesn't go as expected, like this. So it's kind of hard to tell what is wrong here. When you go to your splines, there are all these points here and some of them are bugged and you have no idea which ones. There's an easy way to check that. So if you go to your utilities panel here, click here, click on more, and when you scroll down, you have shape check here. Double click that, pick object, and it's gonna tell you exactly where your problems are. If you zoom here, you're gonna see you have splines intersecting, and if you zoom here, the same thing happens. So a quick solution to that is, you just go to that section, click on the spline, move it here. You can go to your shape check again, pick object to see where the remaining one is, zoom in here, and just fix the issue. And now, when you want to do an extrusion here, you click on extrude, and your model is ready. Thank you guys for watching another episode of Known Unknown Depths of 3ds Max. Hope you learned something. I know I did. Thanks to user Philip Bonham for sharing this amazing mind-blowing feature about select and place pillow mode. Stay safe, happy renderings, and see you in the next video.